It is day six at the 28th World University Games here in Gwangju, Korea, as you take a look at the host city. In today's highlights, we'll look back last night at the badminton team competition between China and Korea. Also from yesterday, Russia takes on Canada in women's volleyball quarterfinal action. United States today takes on Switzerland in basketball. It's the final day of diving, and we'll have two medals to take a look at. And then in shooting, it's the men's 25-meter standard pistol competition. From yesterday on day five at the Hwasun Hanyeom Sports Center, team mixed badminton, Korea taking on China. These two met in the gold medal contest back in Kazan as well, with Korea winning. They have six athletes back, while China just has one, and that's Gao Huan. Here we're looking at mixed doubles. Zhang Wen and U Dong-hee of China taking on Kim Gi-jung and Shin Sung-chan of Korea. Kim is a two-time world bronze medalist. China will take the opening set 21-15 though. Now Korea leading 17-16 here in the second. China cannot return that one. And now Korea with a set point. And that one just long. Korea knots it up at one. We'll head to a third set. Kim serving for Korea. Korea up 13-6. And again, into the net. Korea builds its lead to eight. Get a good look at it here. That one just cannot get over the top of the net. Now at match point. And the backhand there from Kim will prove to be the winner. Korea comes back. They win this third set 21-7 and give Korea a 1-0 overall lead. Now to men's singles. This features Gao Huan of China and Sun Won Ho of Korea. Gao won a silver in men's singles in Kazan, while Sun won silver in the mixed team competition at Kazan. 14-9 right now, Sun in front. Now we'll move to set point, 20-13. Good battle here. Nice backhand clear there by Sun, and the smash. That will give Sun a 1-0 lead. 18-7 now, a commanding lead for the Korean. Gao with the clear, that one almost long. Smash return there. Sun has an answer for everything right now, and there's a smash. Sun 2 points away. Now 1 point away, 20-18. And that smash can't be returned. Korea now up 2-0 as Sun wins that one 2-0. Now men's doubles. This is Zhang and Wang of China taking on Lee and Ko of Korea. The Koreans won gold in men's doubles in Kazan. And a great effort there by the Korean, down on his knees to return that one. Much to the delight of this home favorite crowd. Great backhand there from Korea. And a diving play, Korea all over the place. Picking up more points on their knees than most of us would do on our feet. And you can see why these two were medalists back at Universiade in 2013. 2019 right now here in this opening game. That one into the net. The Korean fans loving it. One match away from winning gold. They need this game to do it. And again from his knees. Ko, an incredible effort here. And again, that smash unreturnable. And Korea now with a commanding 12-5 lead here in this second game. Second gold medal point now, China serving. And that one lands in for Ko. And with that, Korea will win a gold medal in the mixed team badminton competition over China. Thailand and Malaysia will each claim bronze medals. We go back to day five for women's volleyball between Canada and Russia from the Yeomju Gymnasium in Gwangju. This is quarterfinal action. And there you see the teams that have advanced so far. Irina Zaryashko of Russia to serve. She's the only returning player from Russia's gold medal at Kazan in 2013. Now Vanessa Cornwall for Canada, and that serve can't be dug up. Canada back even at 18. There you see a replay of it there. Russia just cannot quite get to that one. Set point now for Russia. They will set it up here for Isayeva. And that will go off Canada and out. Russia wins the opening set 25-20. Canadian fans cheering on their team, trying to get back into this contest. Now Isayeva. That serve can't be returned by Danielle Brisebois. And now Isayeva again, and another ace. That time Kristen Monks thought it was going to head out. You'll get a look at it here from Isayeva's point of view. Just catches the baseline. And now Malkova to serve for Russia. 14-13, Russia up. And there's a set from Cornwall and the kill from Vicky Savard. Canada even again at 14. Now Marie-Alex Bélanger to serve. And Russia will set it up here for Anastasia Barchuk. And that one on set point gives Russia the second set, 25-17, and a 2-0 lead here over the Canadians in this quarterfinal. Third set. Good rally here. But Savard unable to get it through the Russian block. Now move to 12-7, Russia in front. This time the attack works, and Bélanger gets Canada within four. 23-19 now, Russia leading. And Anastasia Bavinka will get it off the Canadian block and it lands in. We're moving now to match point. Here's Bavinka to serve for the match. And Foxier there with the tip, but she's ruled over the net. And that will give Russia a 25-19 victory in the third set and a 3-0 win here in the quarterfinal. They will move on now to the semi where they will take on Japan. Brazil will take on Ukraine in the other semifinal. Canada moves on to take on Colombia in the 5-8 classification round. We're back to the Dongkang College Gymnasium. The United States taking on Switzerland in Group D men's preliminary basketball action. The U.S. 4-0 coming in, Switzerland 1-3. The U.S. get going early. Mason there with the alley-oop to Perry Ellis. The Americans up by 9. Get a good look at that one here. Frank Mason with a beautiful pass and Ellis with the flush. 23-11 now. U.S. will leave Brian Savoy open. He'll knock down the three-pointer here to keep Switzerland in it. The We'll move now to the second quarter. Switzerland only down seven. Here's Florian Steinmann. He'll step back and bank that one in. Switzerland down five. And off the Savoy miss, Landon Lucas will rebound. And eventually the U.S. will work the ball up. Julian DeBose left wide open at the top of the three-point line, and he'll calmly knock that one down. U.S. are up 51-33 at halftime. Now into the third. Here's a steal for the tournament leading scorer, Wayne Selden. Nice pass there to Mickelson. He can't finish. And a battle there. Ball is tied up. It'll be Switzerland's ball. Selden averaging 20.3 points a game coming into this contest. Now it'll be Jonathan Dubas with a size mismatch here over Nicholas Moore. He'll bank that one home. And then right after, U.S. goes back the other way. Wayne Selden right over top of Dubas. You'll get a great look at it right here. Dubas, the hand right in the face of Selden, but it doesn't sway him at all. Now the Americans. Here's Mason again at the top. And an alley-oop backdoor there to Selden for the pretty reverse. As he comes right along the baseline and puts that one home. Now Nicholas Moore finds Carlton Bragg again, the little alley-oop inside, little two-man game in the key. And the Americans pulling away here right now. Dubas, that ball turned over, the Americans back the other way, and Bragg will knock it in. He's fouled as well and will head to the line. And all of this will add up to a 96-57 win for the U.S. Julian DeBose leads them with 18 points and 4 rebounds. Jonathan Dubas for Switzerland leads all scorers with 19. The U.S. will seek its 14th Universiade gold medal. They will head off to the quarterfinal where they will face either Australia or Lithuania. Switzerland is off to the classification round. The final day of diving at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. We'll get rolling with the mixed team event. There's the dive order for the 9 teams that are entered here today.
Team Russia.
We will look first at Daria Gover, a forward 3.5 somersault, difficulty of 3.0. She was fourth in the 3-meter springboard synchro competition earlier. There's a nice overhead look at that dive for Gover. She will score 58.50. Now her teammate, an arm stand back double somersault with 2.5 twists. This is Igor Mialin. Already has a bronze medal in the men's 10-meter platform synchro. Incredible balance to be up that high and then still execute a perfect dive there. Very well done by Mialin.
Total score 86.4. Team Russia.
Clean entry. You get a look at the power and the strength off of that platform. He will score 86.40. Now to Korea. This is a back 3.5 somersault for Kim Yong-nam. He has a silver already from the men's 10-meter platform synchro.
Total score 79.
Bit of a splash on the entry. He'll score 79.20 on that dive. Now for Kim Nam-yi, a forward 3.5 somersault. Already a double medalist here in Gwangju, the silver in the 1-meter springboard and a bronze in the 3-meter springboard. Her score there, 63.
3 meters.
Now the Canadians, a forward 4.5 somersault. This is Cameron McLean on the 3-meter springboard. Good entry there for McLean.
83.6.
And you see those 4.5 somersaults he executes, a score of 83.60.
Second diver,
now his teammate, a back 2.5 somersault with 1.5 twists. This is Selena Toth of Canada. She won gold in the 10-meter platform synchro already earlier on with Carol Ann Ware. A splash on the entry, but still enough to put Canada in a bronze medal spot. Korea will win silver, and Russia takes gold. Now the women's synchronized 3-meter springboard. This is a back 2.5 somersault for Qiu Lin and Su Meng Chen. Qiu has won 4 FINA Grand Prix events in 2015 already in 3-meter springboard. She's looking to add a medal here from Universiade. They'll score 74.70. Now Kim Nam-mi and Moon Nae-yoon. Kim, as you saw moments ago, winning a medal in the mixed team competition, now seeking her 4th medal. They will score 63.84. Now Haley Allen and Olivia Rosendahl of the United States. Pretty well executed synchronization there for the Americans. A little bit of splash on the entry, and that'll give them a score of 60.48. And there you see the final results. Qiu and Soon of China take gold, followed up by Kim and Moon of Korea, and then Allen and Rosendahl win a bronze medal for the United States. You're looking inside the Nanju Jailanamdo shooting range here in Gwangju. There you get a look at the start list for the men's 25-meter standard pistol competition. 28 competitors entered. You'll get a look here at a member of the Russian team. Some of the favorites coming into this, Wang Jiwei finished 3rd in the 50-meter pistol earlier in the week. He was a bronze medalist back at the London 2012 Olympics in the 50-meter pistol. And also Dmitry Breko of Russia, who won gold in the 25-meter rapid-fire pistol earlier in the week. There's a full view of the range. There you see on the left, competitor 1442, that's Andrei Shapetkov. He would finish 6th today. Also, Jean Quicampois of France, who won a bronze in the 25-meter air pistol team competition. There you see him on the right. And it will be Quicampois who ultimately will win the gold medal. Wang wins silver and Breko the bronze.